6 o'clock, time to get started.
Lynn?
Here.
LeeAnn?
Here.
We're going to do two legs on S106. The first one is pointing at the main part of S106. This is a star-forming region.
The EPAWS. We get up to altitude, everywhere you go, this EPAWS goes with you. That's your emergency air. And for those with glasses, you know to put the glasses in before you put the mask on.
My name is George Hademenos, and I am a physics teacher at Richardson High School in Richardson, Texas.
My name is Judi Little. I am from Omaha, Nebraska, and I am a science teacher in a high school.
My name is Diane Watson. I'm a special education math and science teacher, and I teach at Richardson High School near Dallas, Texas.
My name is LeeAnn Vaughan. I am a science teacher from Omaha, Nebraska.
As a physics teacher, what I like to do is search for creative and innovative approaches to enlighten my kids on real-world applications of physics. Although I'm a teacher, I'm also a student as well. I love to learn, I love to engage in these new learning experiences.
They're going to pour over this a ton of data.
What kind of storage are you talking about?
The observatory is expected to collect 3 terabytes of data per flight. Science data is really the bread and butter of SOFIA. That's what we hang our hat on.
Like 10, right?
Uh-huh.
Yep. Like 9. We're starting at 9. We'll do
the nine legs at 6:50. I have always been interested in science. The beauty of having STEM opportunities is that in addition to expanding our information about astronomy is also to learn about data collection and mathematical calculations.
One right, please.
Yeah, we can move it back or different type of integration.
This screen is giving us all the data. So this is still telling us the time end of the flight. It's telling us longitudes, latitudes, timing, altitudes. This is telling us the angle of the telescope. It's telling us whether the telescope is still centered in its bay. How do you hook kids? You know, what's the hook? It's like, well, kids love to see things go kaboom.
Yeah.
Colliding galaxies.
Galactic collision. See that in a book and they're like, hey, we're going to learn about this.
We've looked at galaxies colliding and then the stars that are forming in that area. We're looking at young or new stars, and there's an accretion disk or an area of material that swirls around it, and then how does that affect or influence that star's formation? If I could talk to my high school students right now, I would just say that if you look around, you're going to see why hard work and science and math and all kinds of opportunities out there are worth the effort.
I think that's a satellite. For me, bigger impact really is taking what I'm seeing as far as science in action in just the process of science. Another thing that has been really impressive is watching the problem solving, watching teams of people working together, not just the scientists working together, but also the entire team on board. I just think that's a really important lesson to bring back to our students. How do you go about solving a problem?
You should be able to do this. Go to AOR 209.
So you have 3 different visions, and so they're still looking at these targets. Here, here, here. So even though we're nearly at the end of our journey, we are still infrared telescoping right up until we turn past Las Vegas and go home. How many people at 5 o'clock in the morning are still doing the same excitement, tenacity they were doing at 8 o'clock last night? Awesome.